Hi guys, karibu to my channel. My name is Osei. What's up? What's good? What's happening? In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how I actually straightened my hair before I actually started the protective style challenge. This is something I really wanted to do. I don't know why, but there's always this sense of satisfaction of seeing really kinky hair become straight, and just seeing the length comparison is just like, it's a whole vibe. If you guys are new here and you still want to join the protective style challenge, which helped me to actually grow my hair to this length, all I'm just saying is like, if you just want to join, don't worry, I got you. I have a whole playlist for all of the protective style challenge videos for this year down in the description box. Let me spill them, Shelle, okay? I went to the salon with an old braid out. I had this braid out for a couple of days and I completely loved it. Like, this braid out was just a vibe and I had it for a couple of days. So I just wanted to, like, you know, test the waters. Like, when you go to a salon these days, because of corona, you actually have to schedule your appointment days earlier so they can actually book you in. So I entered the salon with my cousin who was actually helping me film the whole video. Thank you. So basically, when I entered the salon, the first thing they actually did is they tried to comb out my hair, and they obviously, like, did help, because you know how I am when it comes to detangling. I'm telling you, we went into the sink and the salonist who was here was kind enough to actually put conditioner into my hair before he actually washed it, which for me, I was just like, hey. So basically, he kept, like, conditioner in my hair and he started, like, combing it out as gently as possible, which I do appreciate. I love people who try to, like, take care of people's hair as gently as possible. So basically, he detangled my hair for almost like 30 minutes, which was just like, was super long, because he was trying to be as gentle as possible, which I do appreciate. Later on, we did the shampooing and I swear, the massage was heaven sent. The massage was just like, what? This is what I miss. This is the only part I definitely miss, because I felt so good. And I feel like, especially when somebody is dealing with your hair, you know, massaging your hair, there's this, it doesn't really feel the same way. But if somebody else does it, fam. I don't even need to tell you. You already know. You already know. So basically, during this time, after he kept, like, shampooing my hair, he went in with a deep conditioner. I think it was Hair Vitalize, but it didn't really smell or look like Hair Vitalize hair mayonnaise. Probably they kept a product. They kept a product in that container that I didn't even know about. But, like, anyway, after a couple of minutes, he then combed my hair again. I'm telling you, there was a lot of detangling in this whole process, and during that time we're just talking, you know, we're having fun, so, you know, like, we're talking about Edgar Ubare stories, which he does follow, which was really, really fun, and we just had a really fun conversation. Later on, after, like, you know, like, doing the whole deep conditioning treatment, we didn't really go under a dryer. I didn't really feel like going under a dryer because I felt like I was so tired out of all of that detangling. I was just like, Lord, I just want to go straighten my hair and just go home. I am so hungry, you know. So basically, after that, we then went to the blow drying section, and Mr. Bob decided to, like, detangle my hair kidogo again. And then after detangling my hair, he decided to put, like, a leave-in conditioner. I knew it was moving from the moment he actually put it in my hair, because, like, out of all of the products that I have ever bought, I have never liked Movit, and that's why I didn't really, like, do a review on Movit, because, like, even putting it in my hair, I tried it once, I just can't. I do not like the conditioner. I don't know what it is, but, like, it just kind of, like, smells really weird. But that is my own opinion. So basically, he kept in Movit, and after a couple of few seconds, he started, like, blow drying my hair with this round brush. Now, you guys know I'm really, really particular. Even detangling my own hair, I basically finger detangle. Detangling your hair is the main reason why you're not even retaining as much length as possible. Because if you detangle your hair wrongly and you're just snapping off length, all the length that you actually retained, it's going to be a problem. So you stay with the round brush, and after some couple of tries, I was just like, hey man, no, let me not even lie to you. This one, because my ends were snapping off. I was like, Lord, please save my head, you know. So basically, Bob was kind enough and he changed from the brush to actually the normal blow drying brush.
Oh, une faille dans mon cœur attend pour la peinture au mur et les bandes en cul nu. Juste une faille tombe et battant. Le stress est accru par l'ennui vécu. Une feuille tombante, anxiété latente. Pas envie de recommencer ce qu'on foirait les parents. C'est bon, je l'ai vu cru, ça fait aïe aïe. Moi, de toute façon, j'ai besoin de flow et de suite du temps. J'ai besoin d'être sûr que t'es la bonne pour me faire oublier toutes mes peurs et faille, faille.
My hair does not like being straight. It is a resistant queen. It's like, sis, what are you trying to do to me? So basically, after a couple of like minutes, I think it was like 30 minutes of heavy, he's just constantly braiding my hair till it was completely blown out. Then next girl, we went ahead and we started blowing out my hair with a comb, and it was like with this like wooden African combs that you normally find in like Best Lady and everything. I love those combs. I've always liked those combs. I actually have a comb over here that's more African. I just don't know what it is. I think it's more of like the aesthetic vibe that like draws me into that comb, especially those combs, because I find them so pretty and they look so natural and everything. Like, they're just a whole vibe. So basically, he took on a comb and he said like blow drying my hair. Instead of using like a fine tooth comb, he just used that kind of wooden comb that was like finer than the blow dryer comb attachment. So he did it with a couple of tries and he straightened my hair completely. And then later on, this is the part I was actually fearing, because you guys know, like, especially in this tunnel, the reason why I say going natural is because I had like a lot of heat damage, breakage, and just overall damage, you know. So basically, whenever it comes to like people blow drying my hair, I guess I'm a little bit more sensitive, because hey fam, maneno ilianza hivyo too. You know, when he was saying like I hadn't flattened my hair for a long time. I think it's been like over 3 years since the last time I've ever flattened my hair. I used to have a flat iron, but it actually broke. Oh, you guys, I'm telling you, that flat iron just like burnt. It just kind of like exploded. I swear, it just exploded out of nowhere. So basically, the last time I flat ironed my hair was with the flat iron comb, which right now I have to like make an updated review, because that comb just like blew up on me and my friends. So we're gonna talk about that later. Okay, so basically, he flat ironed my hair, and the degrees I think after he was done was like around 420 okay. Obviously I was a little bit nervous. I didn't really, you know, that's a little bit too high, especially for natural hair, but like you know, I wanted to at least give my trust to the professionals and see, you know, just kind of like have that vibe, so I can just be like, okay, he's a professional, you know, just give him, I just wanted to give him space to actually do what he actually does best. And I'm telling you, Bob did not disappoint, because girl, your girl came out of that salon looking like this, eh? Tell me, who is this? bruh, who is this? Really weird for me, but I felt like a completely different person, especially with like my black outfit and I had heels on, girl. Kama mungekuwa huko mungenipeleka Java. I don't know why you guys, wow. Basically, whenever it comes to like straightening my hair, as much as it's a really good experience, you have to keep in mind I was there from like 2 p.m. to like around, no, I was there from like 11 actually to around 2 p.m. So basically 4 hours of me sitting down, detangling my hair, washing, detangling, blow drying, straightening. It was just a really long process. And then 30 minutes later, my hair is like, hey. So basically I ended up, thank God I actually had a rubber band. And if you guys know and you're new to my channel, even on my live I try to have my hair straight within that whole live, but like because of humidity and the heat that was there during that time, my hair just started like growing bigger and bigger and bigger, and your girl ended up with this after a couple of days.
Nyuma tu kidogo.
Nyuma?
Literally kufa.
Hair like literally reverts so fast, and it can be like so annoying sometimes. Cause I think I'm not gonna be straightening my hair anymore, cause like I spent like 4 hours straightening my hair, and then I'm just stuck with like big hair at the end of the day. So basically I don't think I'm gonna blow dry my hair anytime soon, but other than that I really want to thank Bob and his team for actually helping me out and being part of this video. Thank you so much, I appreciate you. I want to appreciate them for actually trying to adapt to like natural hair techniques and everything. They really did a really good job. But personally, I feel like blow drying and me were just gonna take a break, because after 2 times of blow drying my hair, I felt like I had more split ends and I had a little bit of more breakage. Not something like really, really major, but like breakage, especially at my ends, which I'm thinking of actually cutting them off as soon as my scissors come in. I need professional. I ordered some professional scissors. I'm telling you the price. Hey, gods. Why? So basically, before I actually forget, you know your girl has to shout out people. Eh? I wanna thank Dee and Maureen for actually vibing with me and their amazing comments. Girl, nawaona, nawaona, nawaona. If you are new to this channel and you really like my vibe, make sure you subscribe below. And I guess I will see you guys later. Bye. For actually vibing with me and. I want to change. Basically, whenever it comes to like straightening my hair, bruh, it took like 4 hours and then it lasted for like 20 minutes or 30 minutes for it being completely straight. I was just like, girl, madame, why are you being feisty? Why are you being feisty? Why are you resisting change?
Now they wanna play because they're trying to get paid, but they can't because they're too late. We got stacks already making it rain. They can't afford us now. Jump on the jet, switching borders now. Wrote me off when I was 17. Fast forward, they're my employees now.